introduction of SCADA, current trend and leading software solution provider. SCADA functionality, who use SCADA communication protocol system architecture and basic of PLC. So basically SCADA started around its 1960 for industrial process control is applied by electrical system. So this is started by, as I have knowledge, is started by Modicon only. So Modicon is earlier Schneider, Modicon acquired by Schneider. So it's mid 70, the SCADA emerged. So basically this is for automatic control and data acquisition. So all the industry for till 2000 using complete SCADA systems without remote opening, remote operating. So in this condition, we don't need to cover for cyber security because this time is internet is very limited and nobody giving any access to remote. After 2000 internet is launched, then everybody thought we are access for plant from remote and data pushing by some different location. So after that, we need to require for this cyber security also. So this is a basically for this SCADA basics is there. So in this SCADA, we are taking care for paper, sorry, trends, reporting, and this system architecture for device fault indication. So this is a basic of SCADA till 2000. So this is a current trend. Current trend is using by Schneider. The basic good big player is Schneider, ABB, Siemens, Mercenary, Rockwell Automation. So this is a major player in the market for GE, Honeywell, Yokogawa and Omron. So this this company is working is as a globally and globally support also is available. So a major bigger player or bigger companies is using on same thing, same type of manufacturer, any bigger player. Because if maybe somewhere is problem, we are getting support from remote also, and maybe global R&D hub is there for all the companies. So they are providing complete remote support also. And any solution or any programming related or any hardware related issues there. So they also providing some upgraded firmware or as per our requirement, they will customize also if maybe possible. So second, current trend is for SCADA market is programming logical control is PLC, remote terminal unit RTU. Human machine interface, communication systems, and other. Basically programming logical control is just like a PLC. So PLCs not have any feature for data storage. In present scenario is available, but before 2010 is this type of PLC is not available for data log. So earlier we are using as remote terminal unit. So programming logical control basically PLC handle more than 5,000, 6,000 IO. I am working in Schneider in globally done one project. So in this in China, in this this place is working. We are handling for one PLC controller around is 10,000 IOs, including analog input, output, digital, everything. So remote terminal unit have feature for including for your GPRS. Remote monitoring and data storage facility, and you have IEC 104 protocol. Basically IEC 104 or IEC 103 or IEC 102, this protocol is for using for SRLDC, and SRLDC basic for state load dispatch center is there. So state load dispatch center means your electricity board is there, so where is they will maintain for completely plant electricity maintain. So remote terminal unit is basically used for SRLDC purpose or NRLDC or SLDCs. So next is human machine interface. Human machine interface is basically for HMI. So in HMI case, you don't need to require a SCADA. Basically for this is a touch screen. So touch screen means is you have very limited option is there. So if maybe you have plant very small, so can you connect this HMI systems there? And you define as per your requirement. So in HMI is basically for just like a without hard disk, maybe ROM is there only. So very limited space. So just you develop your graphics or animation, what you want, and you communicate this or is providing live status of device. If maybe device is break, but is SCADA is there, then maybe you need to, you taking care for alarm, event, anything is there, report generation. And if you require maybe OPC integration, everything is available with SCADA. Third is, fourth is communication system. Communication system is your for field device to your tail PLC controller, PLC controller to maybe some other devices, maybe server client architecture. So, and from server client architecture, maybe it's, in SCADA have 2-3 layers of communication. First is your industry level communication. So industry level communication is nobody provide you full access from remote. So second is coming is your IT infrastructure. IT is getting limited data, which is required for report development or this report development and for top management data analysis purpose. For maybe some time of taxes or excise or maybe production report for this purpose. And above this is management information system, MIS is there. So this is for completely communication for different layer is there. So SCADA marketed by architecture is for 2-3 devices. One is required for hardware, second is software and services. All three is mixed, then we able to connect off our SCADAs. So presently SCADA application used by different companies, just like oil and gas, power, water and wastewater, transportation and manufacturing, chemical, food and beverage, telecommunication, pharmaceutical or others. And SCADA market by globally is using by approximate presently scenario is all the globe is using by using SCADAs. So leading software solution provided by why we are using for SCADA. So SCADA solution is available for your basically for alarm system response, SOE, communication protocol support, data storage, trends, reporting, third-party connectivity, OPC, DA, UA enabled web client, cloud connectivity, IoT, cyber security, artificial intelligence, animation, and data handling. So basically for alarm system, if we are configured as per equipment safety, maybe so one vibration sensor is there, maybe some rotating device. So in this condition, maybe your vibration is maybe 5 mm, so maybe device is there. So just like a meal is there, raw meal or some cement meal is there. So in this condition, maybe vibration manufacturer is provided, maybe 5 mm is maximum vibration. Otherwise, after that, you need to trip. So in alarm system, you need to define maybe for 3 mm vibration. In this condition, maybe alarm and 4 mm is alarm is high and 5 mm is alarm high and trip. So this is a alarm response time. Response time, what is the SCADA response time? So in this condition is different protocol. It depends up to protocol only. So maybe if you have a Modbus RTU, so response time is 3 seconds, 4 seconds is there. If your Modbus TCP is 1 second or 2 seconds is there, or IEC 61850, in this condition, maybe you'll get maybe milliseconds data. So response time, basically is we are monitoring response time for SCADA display response time. What is the SCADA response, the display time is there. Sometimes SCADA response time may be slow, but SCADA is providing you time as with time stamp. Time stamp means is sequence of event SOE only. So what is the sequence of event? Maybe in 1 second, maybe 1,000 trips, device is tripped. But for as a human, we not able to measure which device trip is first or which in a 1 second, 1,000 device is trip. But SOE is there, so SOE is a measure. Maybe it's 1,000 device of milli or microsecond or till microsecond also is measuring. So which device is trip first, second, third, and is creating completely queue. So SOE is very important basically for thermal power plant and your nuclear power plant. So SOE is very critical role is there. So SCADA depends upon communication protocol support. So communication protocol is lot of communication protocol is there. So just like your Modbus RTU, Modbus TCP, TCP, Ethernet, Profibus, CAN open, and IEC 61850, IEC 104. So lot of different type protocol is there. So Siemens. So every manufacturer has some, every manufacturer, just like a PLC manufacturer, has different type of protocol, proprietary protocol. So is all SCADA need to support for all the, so we need to, when we order SCADA, we are discussing on detail agent, we need to taking care for these things. So which type of SCADA we require. So if otherwise, if maybe different type of protocol is not in this condition, we need to buy some different gateway. So basically this gateway is convert from X protocol to Y protocol as per our SCADA suitable. So in this condition, your time sampling sampling time also is increased and duration also is increased. Maybe data is coming for 1 second if we are providing data. So maybe data time is sampling time is increased for 1 to 1.2 or 1.3 seconds. So data storage also is very much required. So just like renewable energy. So renewable energy is all the companies ask for 24 hours data storage. And if you go in my process industry also ask 1 or 2 years data storage. Basically, why is required data storage? First is maybe any background or anything is there, you need to analysis for with old database. Second is in present market, present market is lot of new technologies available for machine learning or artificial intelligence. So in this condition, we required old data also because developer is using this old data and creating for different type methodology with Python or some different language, and they were creating lot of critical calculations. As per they will start maybe forecasting also when is your device is required maintenance and when you need to when your plant is maybe breakdown of this. So this artificial intelligence is just giving you warning as per old data. Artificial intelligence we are not able to say maybe first day we start plant or artificial intelligence is working. Artificial intelligence working is approximately it will be take maybe 2 years or 3 years data is required minimum. Strains is very required for data analysis purpose. We compare maybe 2, 3, or 5 device pairs parallel, maybe same device is there. So we need to compare which device is performing better and what is the problem. And we need to go on deep analysis and we need to improve for this particular device. And if required any maintenance and any performance related issue and any part we need to replace, we need to taking care from trends database, and same is reporting also. So reporting basically for we need to submit for any process industry, any I'm not saying it's process industry, reporting is required for all the industry. So maybe it's a process industry, maybe your office, any type. So in office also we required for dashboard. Sometimes it's maybe HR or sometimes admin. Everybody is required is a reporting tool. So is process industry also is requiring. So reporting also is lot of factor is there. Sometimes for process people is required is a completely huge log sheets, and top management is required for one page summary sheet, and from director and above is requires they need only for financial. So reports also is different type of reports is available. So this also is part of our SCADA. Third party connectivity, maybe you have one plant is present scenario, and maybe after 1 year, maybe you get maybe some other plant, maybe plant expansion is there. So maybe you get maybe some 90% case is going with same vendor, but maybe after 1 year, this vendor is thinking maybe price is more, is taking price more, is understand ki our system is there. So we are taking good price and when you start to blackmail. So in this condition, maybe when developer go maybe some different vendor, and this interface with old plant to new plant with some third party connectivity tools just like your OPC DA, OPC UA, and some Modbus TCP protocol is there. So you interface for both the plant for one protocol. So if required, maybe you integrate from complete plant, maybe 2 or 3 or 4 vendor you integrate with. And is one more example is there is maybe some Siemens PLC, Schneider, ABB or Rockwell PLCs, maybe 4 or 5 types of PLCs there. So you need to integrate with third party connectivity tools. So all the place maybe you provide maybe Siemens portal, Siemens is using Profibus, Rockwell is using some different protocol, DH Plus is there, and RS Links is there. So you need to take this data and convert with as what protocol you need. Maybe so just I'm giving is maybe Modbus TCP or Modbus Ethernet is required. So we need to convert, provide some using some gateway and convert this protocol to our as per our SCADA gateway, and we need to interface with our SCADA. OPC DA and UA, basically for OPC DA, UA for third party interface is required. Sometimes it's just like I'm giving you example for renewable energy, why is required. So OPC DA basically for your third party in renewable energy, we need to provide data for every 15 minute live data to forecasting agency. If we are not providing forecast live data to forecasting agency, government is giving very huge penalty to us. Approximate is generation. What is the generation is there, maybe 5% of penalties there. So OPC DA basically for third party interface, and OPC UA basically for open protocol, but this is secure protocol. OPC DA is not secure protocol. So due to this reason, we are providing for OPC DA from different, after the firewall one PC we are providing, and OPC after OPC DA also we are providing one more firewall is there. So OPC DUA is basically complete secure protocol is there, encrypted. So you need to define for both the IP and both the end. So you no third vendor maybe interfere in your protocol. So this is a completely secure communication protocol is there. Web client, basically web client is image for your SCADA. So if maybe top management wants key, they also need to using, see what is the plant performance and they need to, see how is plant is performing is there. So in this case, in our SCADA must be support for web client. So in this condition, we need to providing some static IP or internal web IP, and they will access read only access till maybe top management and maybe process experts and maybe third consultant is there. So they access from plant and they will give you suggestion ki how to operate and what you need to in operation, how you improve. So these things is there. So after this, cloud connectivity / IoT. So present scenario is IoT or cloud connectivity is more than 50% is industries start using for IoT or cloud connectivity. Basically they are this cloud and IoT is basically just like your plant operation only, but critical process we are not using for cloud connectivity and IoT, because sometime maybe due to internet speed or something, maybe response time is slow. So all the operation should be locally only, but all the related process data or the process data related to report or trends, everything is available or directly pushed to cloud. So in this condition, you need to it's a cloud. So just like presently in India is providing by maybe Azure is there, or Amazon is there. So it's providing cloud. So basically they are providing for, as per our specific, they will provide on remote location, some cloud provision is there. So basically this is a VM waiver is there. So virtual machine is there. So virtual machine, they are providing a static IP. So you need to use static IP, push all the data is there and you access from remote. And generate report as per your requirement, you generate your dashboard. So a lot of third party tool is there, just like a Pi is there. So you maybe use Pi and you generate as per your requirement dashboard and reporting and what analysis you want and data validation, everything is available with some software, third party software is there. So next is cyber security. Cyber security in present scenario, if you are using cloud or IoT and OPC UA DA, so must be you need to taking care for cyber security. Otherwise, maybe some third party or maybe your old employee, maybe is due to some reason is left from organization. So I think they also have password. So in this condition, we need to taking care completely cyber security. Otherwise, they also, this guy also maybe sometime is coming and access and creating problem. So every as per policy, if any your employees left from our organization, you need to change your frequent or disable this user. And after that, you need to be taking care from a third party help for cyber security audit. And cyber security may be using is good firewall and good antivirus softwares. So artificial intelligence, I've already explained here. Animation is basically for graphical graphical view. So in what is the benefit of animation? So maybe it's a drive is maybe your drive or any pump, water pump is there, so maybe running condition is there. So maybe showing is green color and drip is for maybe red color and maybe overload is blinking. So it's different type of animation is there, just like your water tank is there, so it's showing is as 420 million. Analog signal is there, animation. Maybe water tank maybe 10 meters. So it's in animation is showing is what is the water level is there. So the animations, if required, we are using is multiple way on animation. So and data handling is basically for we need to taking care in design stage for how much data we need to handle, how much storage is required. So every part is considering before engineering, we need to taking care for this. Sometimes we are taking for maybe our SCADA is not able to handle for this much of data. So in this case, we are taking separate PC for is a historian server. So we are take SCADA collect all the data and push to historian server. Because of if you are playing with SCADA, so sometime maybe due to database is used, maybe SCADA is, itself is creating problem. So SCADA taking all the data from field or maybe third party, what is source is available is pushing directly to storage server. So basically for SCADA functionality so in SCADA basically have your digital or analog signal is there. So digital is input for just like your proximity switch or your limit switch is there. So all the input is available. So this is for digital input. Analog is your 400 million signal is there. So just like your drive status, drive what is the RPM is there, how much current is there, how much volt is there. This is for analog input. So analog input is coming with communication also. And this all the signal is coming with the communication or as well as this physical input also is there. So this and the RTU remote terminator, these are a small computerized unit deploy the field a specific site and location. So basically this is for local collection point, gathering report from sensors, generating commands for control relay, and this is directly pushed to data as per your requirement. A place maybe on cloud or maybe your local storage. So local laptop, maybe you connect your local laptop or take all the data from RTU. So data present is a collect data is processed, organized and presented for system operator to make appropriate response and control decision. The presentation can vary from regular presentation of logged event or graphical presentation against mapping or image background. So this is for data mapping. Basically for if we are using a PLC or SCADA, we need to and field devices, the field device also we need to mapping for PLC input output signal is there. And after that, we need to map PLC signal to SCADA. So just like in PLC, we are providing for input number 1. And SCADA maybe is input number 10. So we need to map this completely. And input 10, we need to define for different color. One input may be red or maybe healthy or fault status. Maybe 2 input is there. So we need to combination maybe 3, maybe on, off, or trip. So this way we need to providing data presentation on SCADA screens. Control is for basically we need to control for maybe some drive, soft starter, or maybe wave feeder, and maybe inverters. So we need to control maybe on off, maybe your set point unit is just like I'm giving you example for your home. Is fan is there. So sometimes we are using for 5-step or 4-step fan regulator. Presently we are before 5-6 years we are using for electronic regulator. Presently we are taking this remote. So we need to increase step by step for speeds, maybe 10-step or 20-step. If we are converting 5-step to 20-step or 30-steps. So these things we need to be a control maybe on off, just like your AC also is there. So you need to control fan speed and temperature. And if you require to stop also, this is a control.